So hi everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session, as usually, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. And guys, from today onwards, the sessions will be conducted at this time only, Monday, Wednesday and Friday at 9 PM. Alright, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed, and you can also ask your doubts here. You can also follow me here. Here also you can ask anything related to examinations. Alright, so let's talk about the very first question. Very, very important question. Huge chance for it to come in your exam. Consider the following statements with respect to scheme for strengthening of pharmaceutical industry, and you have to identify the correct statement. So, the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers has released the guidelines for this particular scheme, and that's why it is in news. Alright, so let's talk about the scheme. The news is that the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, which is headed by Mr. Mansukh Mandavia, has released the detailed guidelines for the scheme for strengthening of pharmaceutical industry. Now talking about the scheme, so first of all, let's try to identify the objective. So as I already always told you, मैंने हमेशा बताया है आपको that objective can easily be extracted from the name of the scheme itself. So what is the name? Scheme for strengthening of pharmaceutical sector, which means the government is intended towards strengthening of pharmaceutical sector. Now how the pharmaceutical sector can be strengthened? Of course, some kind of financial assistance will be provided. All right, and किसी भी sector को strengthen करने के लिए सबसे important चीज क्या होती है? The most important thing for strengthening a particular sector is the infrastructure. Alright, so that is the objective. To strengthen the existing infrastructure facilities in the pharmaceutical sector in order to make India a global leader in the sector. Alright, that is the objective. So this is how you can easily identify objective from the name of a scheme itself. Alright, it has been launched with a total outlay of ₹500 crores, and the financial assistance will be provided for development of, or you can say for improvement of, infrastructure facilities under this particular scheme. All right and of course the ministry, the implementing ministry, is Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, headed by Mansukh Mandavia. Now there are three components of this scheme. Okay, very important, there are three components of this particular scheme. Number one is assistance to pharmaceutical industry for common facilities. Assistance to pharmaceutical industries for common facilities is the very first component. It is for strengthening the existing pharmaceutical clusters capacity for their sustained growth. And how this will be done? This will be done by creating common facilities. Common facilities banai jayengi so that jo pharmaceutical cluster hai usko aur zyada strengthen kiya ja sake. Alright. The outlay for this component will be ₹178 crores, take it out of 500. All right. The second component is pharmaceutical technology upgradation assistance scheme. Under this component, financial assistance will be provided to the MSMEs. Jo MSMEs hai, unko financial assistance provide hoga either through interest subvention or through credit linked capital subsidy. Take it. This financial assistance will be provided in two modes. Number one, in either of the two modes. Number one is through interest subvention, and number two is through capital linked subsidy, credit linked capital subsidy. All right in case of interest subvention, maximum of 5% per annum in case of general category MSME owner. But if it is the case of SC ST owner, then in that case interest subvention will be how much? 6%. Okay, now in the case of credit linked capital subsidy, how much percent? 10% of credit linked capital subsidy will be provided. All right and the total outlay for this component is how much guys? ₹300 crore. 300 crore iska total component hai, total outlay hai. Now the third component is pharmaceutical and medical devices promotion and development scheme. Basically the awareness will be generated in this particular component. So the objective of this component is to facilitate growth and development of pharmaceutical and medical devices sectors through awareness generation programs. All right and for this the outlay is 21.5 crores. 21.5 crore ka iska outlay hoga is component ka. Theek hai, so the total outlay will be approximately how much? 500 crores. So that's it about this scheme, and now let's come back to the question. And isse zyada detail mein padhne ki zarurat nahi hai is scheme ko. Please डोंट गो through the detailed guidelines of this scheme, that is not important for the exam. जितना यहाँ पे हमने पढ़ा इतना ही पूछा जाएगा, इससे ज्यादा is not important. So you have to identify correct statement out of these three. The scheme is being implemented by Minister of Health and Family Welfare. So दवाइयों का नाम सुन के या pharmaceutical sector का नाम सुन के there can be a confusion between Ministry of Health and Ministry of Chemicals. But do remember, this ministry is Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers, which is implementing it. Number two, total outlay is 1000 crore. Is that so? No, it's 500 crores. And there are five components of the scheme. No, there are not five components. There are three components of the scheme. So this is also incorrect. So all the statements are incorrect here, which means option D, none is correct, should be the correct answer. All right, now let's move ahead to question number two. Under which initiative Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs headed by H.S. Puri, Hardeep Singh Puri, who is also the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, has launched India Water Pitch Pilot Scale Startup Challenge. Now guys, in such type of challenges, please don't go into the details of these challenges. Okay, that is absolutely not required. You just have to remember the ministry or the organization or the department which has launched this challenge, number one, and number two, for what objective this challenge has been launched. That is more than enough. Usse zyada karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Now let's talk about this. So Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched India Water Pitch Pilot Scale Startup Challenge. And as the name suggests, it is for supporting startups in the water resources sector. Alright. So what will happen in this? 100 startups will be selected and they will be provided up to a maximum of rupees 20 lakh. Kitne diye jayenge? 20 lakh rupees diye jayenge as funding support, and along with that mentorship will also be provided. Okay, and it has been launched under Amrit 2.0, which was launched last year. Okay, Amrit 2.0 last year launched hua tha, usi ke under is challenge ko launch kiya gaya hai. Okay, that's it. Isse zyada padhne ki there is no need in this particular news. Okay, and any news related to challenge itna hi padhna chahiye, like under which initiative this challenge has been launched, by which ministry the challenge is launched, and what they are doing under this challenge. Okay, so that is more than enough. Therefore the correct answer will be what? The question is regarding under which initiative, so that's Amrit 2.0. option B is the correct answer. All right, so I hope this question is clear. Now let's move ahead to question number 3. Which of the following institutions has signed an MOU with Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency, which in short is IREDA, for solarization of its campuses? IREDA के साथ MOU किया है कौन सा institution ने अपने campuses को solarize करने के लिए? Okay, so this institute guys is CIPET, which is Central Institute of Petrochemical Engineering and Technology. ठीक है, and the objective is clear from the question itself. This MOU has been done to provide under this MOU, the technical and financial expertise of IREDA will be provided to the CIPET for solarization of its campus. उसके campuses को solarize करने के लिए ये MOU किया गया है, and the very first projects will be started from Varanasi, Ayodhya and Bidar. Varanasi and Ayodhya are in Uttar Pradesh, Bidar is in Karnataka. Alright, so MOU may be, again you just have to read about the organizations between which the MOU has been signed, number one, and number two, the objective of that MOU. Okay, that is it. So therefore the correct answer will be what? CIPET. Option B, CIPET is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 4. With which of the following universities ICMR has signed an MOU for capacity building for Indian scientists and researchers? Now this is not the only MOU which has been approved for signing by ICMR. Three MOUs have been approved by Union Cabinet for signing by ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research. Who is the Director General of ICMR? Professor Balram Bhargav, BB. Professor Balram Bhargav is the Director General of ICMR. Now three MOUs have been approved. Number one is between ICMR and DFG Germany. DFG ke full form yaad karne ki zarurat nahi hai. It is a German name, jo ki not important at all. So this is for cooperation in the field of health research in the areas including toxicology, okay, rare diseases, neglected diseases and any other areas of mutual interest. ठीक है. सो नंबर वन एमओ यू विल बी बिटवीन ICMR एंड DFG जर्मनी. द सेकेंड MOU will be among three organizations. Number one is ICMR. Number two is National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, which is in USA. Number three is National Institute of Health of Department and Human Services, which is again in USA. And the objective of this MOU is only the medical research. ठीक है, medical research के लिए ये वाला MOU sign होगा. And number three is between ICMR and Oxford University of UK. This is for capacity building of Indian scientists and researchers. जो हमारे देश के साइंटिस्ट हैं और रिसर्चर्स हैं, उनकी कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग की जाएगी अंडर दिस पर्टिकुलर MOU. Alright, so these three MOUs have been approved for signing by ICMR. And this question is regarding capacity building for Indian scientists and researchers. And for this, the MOU has been signed between ICMR and Oxford University of UK. Alright, so option C is the correct answer. I hope this question is clear. Now let's move ahead to question number 5. What will be the share capital of newly approved National Land Monetization Corporation? Now what is this? This is something new. National Land Monetization Corporation, it was announced in this year's budget. Jo is saal ka budget tha, usme announced kiya gaya tha. And for this, approval has been given by the Union Cabinet. So Union Cabinet has approved the setting up of National Land Monetization Corporation. Now what is this? What will it do? So it will undertake monetization of surplus land. ठीक है, जो भी surplus land होता है central public sector enterprises का, उसको monetize करने का काम करेगा. ठीक है, the surplus land of the CPSEs will be monetized by this corporation, and also it will build assets of CPSEs and other government agencies. ठीक है, जो भी सरकार की surplus land है, उसको monetize करने का काम करेगा. And how it will do that? ये हम आगे पढ़ेंगे जब ये प्रॉपर पूरी तरीके से एस्टैब्लिश हो जाएगा. ठीक है, अभी इसके एस्टैब्लिशमेंट की सिर्फ अप्रूवल आई है. अभी ये सारी डिटेल्स हमें नहीं पता कि हाउ दिस कॉर्पोरेशन विल डू द मोनेटाइजेशन ऑफ सरप्लस लैंड. दिस इज स्टिल नॉट नोन. इट विल बी सेट अप एज अ होली ओन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया कंपनी विद अ शेयर कैपिटल ऑफ रुपीज 5000 करोर एंड पेड अप शेयर कैपिटल ऑफ रुपीज 150 करोर्स. ऑलराइट, इतना ही है अभी, इससे ज्यादा नहीं है. इससे ज्यादा तब होगा जब ये प्रॉपरली एस्टैब्लिश हो जाएगा. सो हियर द क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग शेयर कैपिटल, दैट इज हाउ मच रुपीज 5000 करोड़. सो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. आई होप दिस क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, 7, 8 आर डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, वी डू नॉट हैव टू गो इन टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ दीज क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, दीज आर यू नो वन मार्क क्वेश्चन. विद विच इंटरनेशनल बैंक Government of India has signed a loan agreement worth $125 million for providing support to help poor and vulnerable groups. Okay, and remember, this loan has been signed for the government of West Bengal, or you can say just West Bengal. This much amount will be given to West Bengal, and the objective is for providing support to help poor and vulnerable people. Okay, and the bank is what? World Bank. Option D. World Bank is the international bank with which this loan agreement has been signed by the government of India. So in such type of questions, you just have to remember three or four things. Four things. Number one, the amount. Number two, the international bank. Number three, the state for which the loan has been taken. And number three, the objective for which the loan has been taken. These four things you just have to remember, nothing more than that. All right. So here the correct answer is World Bank, headed by David Malpass, and it is headquartered in Washington DC. Moving ahead, which of the following PSUs has been awarded the first prize under Swachhta Pakhwada Awards presented by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas headed by HS Puri? So Swachhta Pakhwada Award diya hai Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas ne for only to the organizations under working under this ministry only. Theek hai, because the overall awards are given by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Theek hai. So this PSU guys is IOCL, ranked number 1. Number 2 pe it was ONGC, number 3 pe HPCL. Alright, so IOCL is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 8, which is the last question for today. How many farmers were awarded during Pusa Krishi Vigyan Mela? Krishi means farming, Vigyan means science, and Mela means fair. 2022 organized by ICAR, Indian Institute of Agricultural Research, with the theme self-reliant farmer with technical knowledge. So इस question में ही सारी information है with respect to this news. ठीक है, so news क्या है? पूसा कृषि विज्ञान मेला 2022 was organized. It was organized by which organization? ICAR, IARI, which is Indian Institute of Agricultural Research. What was the theme? Self-reliant farmer with technical knowledge. So these three informations are already given in the questions. ठीक है, तो इसलिए मैं इसके लिए अलग से न्यूज नहीं बनाता हूँ. क्वेश्चन में ही सारी चीजें कवर्ड है. ऑलराइट, सो हाउ मेनी फार्मर्स वर अवार्डेड? 41 फार्मर्स वर अवार्डेड ड्यूरिंग दिस इवेंट. ऑलराइट, and that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.